Today's show is about telling your parents that you're gay. Now, we knew when we were putting the show together that we'd be talking to some amazing people with some scary, great, funny, sad, happy experiences. But what we didn't expect was a phone call from our first guest, Bill, telling us that he wants to come out to his mom on the show. See, she doesn't know that he's gay, which is why I'm explaining this to you before they get here, which is also why I'm dressed the way I am. Bill said he wants to do this on TV because he wants to give other people in this situation some ideas about how they might go about telling their parents. It's not like there's a handbook for this kind of thing, you know? I want you guys to meet our first guests here, Bill and Cleo. Cleo's the mom, and Bill is the son. Now, tell me about your relationship. What's it like?
I love my mother a great deal, and I think that she's sacrificed incredible amounts of things in her life in order to be able to provide me with an education and to really make my life have the opportunities that on some levels she never had when she was growing up, you know, in Mexico before she came to this country. So at the same time, you know, I really respect my mom too. She's really been a role model for me in everything that I've ever done, and she's always challenged me incredibly. And I love her deeply, and I want her to know that, you know, Mother's Day is here, and I want her to know that I love her deeply. She's really been the sort of model for me in growing up.
Cleo, you look happy. You look proud. Look at those tears in her eyes already. Well, tell me how you feel about your son.
Oh, well, I am very proud of him that he has accomplished all of the things he has, and at the same time, I know he's going to get farther because he's a very hard worker.
Yeah. When I was growing up, though, there was also the sense that I had to act a certain way sometimes to get love or to feel accepted by my family. And a lot of times that had to do with the idea that I had to act like a man in a certain way, or that there was an idea that I couldn't do certain things because those were associated with other kinds of, you know, lifestyles or whatever. Like, I couldn't cross my legs this way because this was already considered effeminate, you know? Mm-hmm. Or I couldn't walk across a room because that might, you know, give relatives an idea that I might not be, you know, like other people. So, you know, that was very difficult for me because sometimes, like, I wouldn't even be thinking about myself in any particular way, and then my mother would come up afterwards and say, "Why did you do that? Why did you act that way? Don't do that." And it was often really difficult for me to do, you know, to deal with that, because I felt that sometimes love was contingent upon acting a certain way.
Cleo, how do you feel about that? Do you think that's true? Do you feel like did you intentionally give him that message that he shouldn't act a certain way?
I don't think it was intentional. It was probably part of my upbringing, the way that I thought that things were right. Okay. And I just wanted to bring him up the same way probably that they had brought me up.
Okay, so Bill, if you were going to say like the one thing that's not so great maybe in your relationship or where the friction might be, is that what it's about mainly?
I think it's about that, and you know, it runs deeper than that. I don't feel that I've been particularly honest with my mom about my life until now.
Okay, let's go ahead to why you're here. You wanted to come on the show today for a specific reason.
Yeah. Mom, I wanted to tell you that I love you very much, and that I wanted to come here in front of all these people today because I want to tell you that I'm gay, and I want you to continue loving me despite the fact that I'm gay, or because I'm gay. You know, I don't want that to be something that stands between us, and I want to involve you. I want to involve you in the rest of my life, and I want you to be there the way you've always been there for me from day one. And I want to take care of you the way you took care of, you know, my grandmother, and I want you to participate in my life the way that I know that you want to. And I don't feel that I've been able to do that because I've had to keep this other part of myself from you. And I don't want that to stand between us anymore. And I love you very much. So on Mother's Day this year, I wanted to give you that, the life that I've hidden from you, because I love you very much.
Cleo, how do you want to respond to him?
Well, you You got me wrong, because you are my son. And it doesn't matter how you are, you're still my son. And whatever it is that you choose to do in life, it's your life. And I have always taught you to do whatever you think is best for yourself, and just to try and be the best you can for the world, for yourself. So that doesn't change nothing, nothing at all.
But I know that you think that that maybe because I'm gay that you did something wrong in bringing me up, and I know that you think that that I might be abnormal, or that being gay is like abnormal. And I know that, you know, we believe very strongly in the church, and the church says that I'm abnormal and sick or something. And I don't think that you can live with me and accept me and still have those opinions. You know, I think we need to work together to change that, you know.
Well, yeah, I understand what you are saying, and maybe if I learn more about it, I can change my opinion, but you know very well that as old as I am, it's going to be kind of hard, but we'll work at it.
Cut that off.
You know, I want to say one of the reasons that we wanted to have you on here, Cleo, is because you do have such a strong relationship with your son. And we felt like if anybody was going to have this reaction in this forum, it would be you. And hearing you say that, just that means so much to me that you are willing to, you know, to try to learn, to even accept this more than you already do. Wow. It's really beautiful. It really is. What did you want to say?
I got a question. How old were you when you first realized, you know, the feelings about you were gay?
I've always known that I was gay from, like, when I was in preschool. I went to this preschool, and there was this time we had to role play and do, like, a family kind of thing, right? And I always wanted to be the mom. And because I love my mother. And and I really, you know, I think from then on I knew that there was a certain part of me that was different from other people, and that acting a certain way was not okay. So I knew I had to hide from, like, as early as I can remember, you know. And I knew, you know, when I hit adolescence, I knew I was attracted to men, period, even before then. So it wasn't even like I had to wait till then to figure it out.
Okay. This guy won't let me leave. I've got another question.
How old were you when you first started going out to, you know, actually having, you know, relationships or experiences with other guys?
Well, I went to an all-boys Catholic high school in Chicago. And I actually chose to go to that high school because I thought that it would butch me up and make me a man, and maybe that this was just a phase. You know, I'd listened to other talk shows and things, and sometimes I'd heard psychologists and things get on the talk shows and say, well, what you repress is what comes back. So I thought, well, as long as I accept myself to myself, you know, as long as I accept that this is the way I am in my own life, then it'll go away. And by the time I hit high school, it didn't, you know. So I didn't really do anything in high school. I think throughout all of high school, I kept trying to sort of play this game and provide my mother with the kind of image that she wanted to see for me. And I took these, like, women that she'd never seen before to the prom and to homecoming my senior year. And now I've been in school, I go to Yale, and for everybody out there, there are plenty of gay people at Yale. plenty of gay people at Yale. Yale is also not the place to try and find anybody to date. So, because people are working really hard all the time.
Men or women, or whoever they want to date. Okay.
Yeah. So I've had some relationships with people, but nothing really, like, substantial, because everybody's really, like, trying to grind. Anyway.
Cleo, what are your fears about this? Are there things that you're worried about for him?
His health. But I believe that all through his growing up, I have always made him aware of what's out there and what the dangers are. And
when you're talking about AIDS,
right?
Fear,
mm-hmm. And what could you know that. And I believe that regardless of which ever partner he picks, I believe he will take care of himself.
Yeah, because that's a fear, whether he's gay or straight or whatever. It's not
just
about that. Did you understand that? One other thing, did you always know, like he's talking about how he always knew, did you have it in your head somewhere?
Yes.
You did?
Yes, I did.
You did.
We used to talk about it.
So from when? From when?
Well, if I think about it right now, I can tell you from when he was in preschool. But it was one of those things that, you know, you see and you just pass it around, you know, you don't think about it. They had their show at the end of the year, and he wanted to be a witch.
And I went to a costume party at the end of my, you know, preschool year dressed up as a witch. And she put the makeup on and, like, did everything for me. So
yes, I did.
So you wondered even from
then. Yeah,
there.
But then later on, he went to France. And when he come back, he start seeing some magazines and stuff that it kind of put things on my mind, but I just never...
What magazines?
What kind do you think?
Did you know that she saw those?
Well, it's so weird. Well, it's not like I had them out everywhere, you know. I put them in an appropriate enough place in the closet in my room and didn't deal with them at all. And she must have found them during one of the times that I was away at school and threw them out, but never said anything to me about ever having found them. And I mentioned to her that they were gone, and I wanted them back, and she totally just pretended that, you know, they did not exist. And if they did, she wouldn't want that, you know, filth or whatever in her home. Mm-hmm. It was important for me to see representations of myself, mm-hmm. you know, so I knew where to put what or whatever. So, I mean, I don't know about the other sort of things that she assumed about it.
Okay, one real quick question for you.
I guess being gay means you can't have the traditional family, you know, father, son, father, mother, children. Does that bother you?
You're asking the mom or the son?
No, the son.
Bill, does that bother you, the idea of not being able to have kids? And
I'm not entirely sure what you mean. I've always been very close to my mother, and my father and I have had a rocky relationship, but I'm close to him in some ways, too. So I've always felt very supported. I'm an only child, and they've really showered me with
but
love
what
and
what about
support.
You, I guess she's getting at you not being able to have kids of your own and having that traditional kind of family unit?
Who said I can't have kids of my own necessarily? Maybe one day I might try and do that. I mean, maybe society is changing so that I might be able to do that. And I might think about adopting.
Adopt.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I think I really would think about adopting. I want to raise kids at some point.
Okay.
I know my mom is very, very concerned about having kids because since I was an only child, I think she needs other little babies in the house.
Do you want grandkids?
Of course.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Well, maybe you'll still get them.
I hope.
He's saying maybe. Okay. We're going to have to take a break. When we come back, we're going to meet a family. I'm so proud of these guys. We're going to meet a family where it wasn't so easy for them. You're amazing.
You already know. You know exactly why. You want me to say it?
Now lower your voice.
No! You want me to say it? You want me to say it, Mom? I didn't swerve to avoid hitting a dog. I swerved to avoid living this life. So if it'd be better to be dead,
all right.
I'm gonna tell you that. No, you haven't, Mom! No, you haven't. I tried to kill myself.
No, you didn't. You had an accident.
No! 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 I thought it'd be better to be dead.
No!
Mom! I thought it'd be better to be dead than to.
No!
Yes! Than to tell you I was gay!
I'm going to carry around my tissues now for the rest of the show because that really got to me. But I want you guys now to meet Kevin and Margaret. And Kevin, tell us, you're here on satellite, I should tell people, but tell us about when you came out to your mom.
Well, Jane, I guess my mom always knew that I was gay. And it wasn't really until, say, 18 or 19 that we even discussed it. But whenever I was 14 and 15 in high school, I was dating other boys. I was dating a basketball player from another high school. And my mom had been snooping in my room during a couple of times, and I think she found a letter that he had written to me about how much he loved me and how much he cared for me. And she confronted me about that, and I totally said that it was over, that I was different, and it was just a phase that I was going through. And it kind of got put on the back burner for several years. But I felt that I had to say to my mom that I was just going through a phase and that wasn't how I was.
Okay. So, Mom, when you found out, it was a while ago now since you found out.
Yes.
And what was your reaction?
I thought, oh, this has to be a mistake. This really couldn't happen. He's such a wonderful kid that I accepted it as a phase, but probably deep in my heart, I knew it, at that time that it wasn't. But it was much easier for me to deal with it at that time, to sweep it under the carpet, more or less, and just forget about it and try to go on with our life like it was.
So now, I guess now you know that it wasn't just a phase.
That's true, it wasn't.
Okay, how do you feel about that? How did that affect your relationship with him?
Well, to be quite honest, Kevin and I saw each other about 2 weeks ago for the first time in over a year. And it was a struggle. I had to deal with the fact if I really had the courage to see him. But we had a wonderful visit and aired some things and got some things out in the open, and I think we're going to be able to build from that.
Mm-hmm. So you feel like now, as of this last 2 weeks, your relationship might be getting better?
Yes.
When you say the courage, what was the fear?
I was just afraid to see him face to face, because I've dealt with a lot of the things, and my thinking is, well, my thinking right now vacillates from day to day. One day I may feel one way and another day another. But I'm trying to grow and to learn what his feelings are and accept him for who he is, because he is my son.
Okay. Kevin, you have a boyfriend now?
Yes, I have a permanent partner.
Okay. And has he been introduced to your mom?
Yes, he has. We've been together for going on a little over 2 years right now. And he spoke to my mother on the telephone.
People are clapping. They like monogamy in here, I guess. Okay.
And he spoke to my mother on the telephone shortly after we got together and decided to have a committed relationship. My mom really wasn't at a space, I think, that she wanted to hear a lot of the things that he had to say to her. He told her that, you know, it's just not fair that the way that they treat me. If I had come from even the most dysfunctional of black families, for instance, and I had gone to school and been called and could have come back home, and my parents, even in the most dysfunctional families, would have given me the love and the support because they are black together with me. Mm-hmm. And he's trying to explain to her that, look, two straight people don't set out to have a gay son. And you, as gay parents, can't imagine the pain that I went through to go to school and to be called a faggot and to be called different and to come home and be have that pain alone and to not be able to share that with anyone. And if I did share it, to know that I'm subject to some judgments.
Did you ever try to share that with them? Did you ever bring that up, that kind of stuff that was the bashing kind of stuff that was happening?
No, I didn't. I mean, that's a huge fear. If you have, you know, you've got Bill who says Cleo told him, always be the best that you think that you can be. I had parents that say, always be like this book, the Bible says. And that's just something that I was taught is not acceptable. How am I going to say to them, hey, I'm this way, there's nothing I can do about it?
Okay.
Yeah, but I wasn't necessarily exonerated from still holding up a certain kind of image from my parents. Mm-hmm. You know, going to an all-boys Catholic school was obviously not something that I did out of, you know, just a random thing. I went because I wanted to provide my parents with a certain kind of image.
Mm-hmm.
And even there, I mean, especially in an all-male environment, you can't imagine, maybe some people who are straight can't imagine, how horrible it is to sort of, you know, sit around and have other people literally degrade you because you're gay, or
right.
or talk about gay people, you know, in front of you
right.
and just say disgusting things for no reason. It's mm-hmm. not a rational
right.
hatred. It's just hatred.
Kevin, how did you feel about this last visit with your mom, and how do you feel, do you feel she's getting along well with your partner?
I brought Joel, my partner, with me to dinner, and it was a little difficult, a little tense at moments. We talked about some things and why I felt rejected, and I guess underlying it all was hurt. I mean, I was extremely hurt by my parents, and that they thought that I was in some way defective because I'm gay.
You mean as a child, or you mean even now you feel that?
I feel that right now.
Mm-hmm. Margaret, how do you respond to that? Do you feel he's in some way, in any way defective, or are you having a hard time dealing with this still?
No, I don't feel that he's a defective person. I have basically come, I think I'm rationalizing and coming to grips as to who he is and what he is. And we had a long discussion the other night. I don't know if we can go into this. I don't know that this was really his choice for him to be gay. I'm dealing with that right now and searching through that to see what it is. But Kevin is a wonderful human being, and I love him for who he is and not necessarily for okay. what he is.
But when you say rationalizing, I mean, what do you mean by that? How are you coming to terms with it?
Well, I'm doing a lot of reading and studying and also soul searching myself to kind of digging down deep within myself.
Are you open with your friends and other people about
no,
it?
No, I haven't gotten that far yet.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So when your friends ask you about him and stuff like that?
I just, you know, he lives on the West Coast. He's doing fine. Everything's going well for him.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
But yeah, Jane, most of my mom's friends are in the church also, and I think that has a lot to do with it. She's embarrassed because she has someone that they think that they won't accept. I mean, their beliefs and what they practice as far as religion not only hurts me very deeply, hurts my relationship, hurts my partner Joel, and hurts millions and millions of other people in this country and in this world.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're gonna take a quick break. You stay standing up because I will talk to you.
Ever have a friend steal your lover?
My girlfriend knew how I felt about him, but sharing my clothes wasn't enough for her. She had to have my man.
Next Jane, ex-best friends face to face. Meet girls and guys who say, my best friend stole my lover.
Monday at 5 on Fox 5.
Does your mom or dad think you dress like a tramp? Tell us what bugs your parents about your clothes and how you defend the way you look. And you could be getting all dressed up to be on TV. Call 212-730-8103.
Kevin, how do you feel about, what do you think your mom's response to your partner is and to this choice you're making? I mean, do you feel like she's being straight with us here about how she feels, or?
No, I don't. I feel that my mother, because of maybe her background and her upbringing or whatever, but I feel my mother believes that I have a choice in the matter. And I think that she has even said to me and to us the other night at dinner that she believes that it's no different from someone whose parents have a child who is a murderer, that they have to learn to deal with it. Well, I'm sorry, I'm not a murderer, and there's nothing wrong with being gay, and I want you and everyone else to know that.
Did you actually say that it was like being a murderer? And
I don't recall that's were the words that were used. Kevin, was that, did we use the words? I'm sorry, please refresh my memory.
I think so.
Okay.
I think, I mean, because the key point is here that, I mean, a murderer hurts other people. An alcoholic even, you know, hurts themselves. And I don't think that's what this is about. It's not about something that hurts other people or yourself.
We just want to be human beings.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. I want to introduce you also. This is Dennis. And you also had, you have a coming out story of your own. Tell us what it is.
It happened on October 11th, which is National Coming Out Day. And it was a coincidence that happened. I thought that I would literally die if my parents knew that I was gay. I thought that I would kill myself. And when my mother approached me and said, you know, started throwing comments, she started putting down gay people, and that really hurt me, and that has left an emotional scar in my life forever. After she initially came out and said, are you gay? I said, yes. She started screaming. She started saying that, she started telling me that it's not right. Wait until your grandparents find out. This really hurt me because I love my family dearly and I would never want to do anything to hurt them. And when my mother, when I had to face my mother and actually say, Mom, yes, I am gay, it bothered me.
It was hard for you to have to
yep.
say that because you knew how she was going to take it?
Yes. I knew my parents were born again Christians and I knew that my mother was going to go off. And I knew that I was going to have to live the rest of my life in pain.
And what's happened since then, since you told her?
Not much. Not much. We have our ups and downs. I don't think they'll ever understand. They're very close-minded. Very close-minded. I've tried to see both sides, and I've tried to look at their side, and it's really hard to understand that they, the God that I know wouldn't say things that they say. Mm-hmm. I know that God loves me, mm-hmm. and my mother tells me that I'm going to hell, mm-hmm. and I don't believe that.
Mm-hmm. So,
do you have a
relationship with your mom now?
I love my parents dearly. And I just want my mom to know that I will always love her, no matter what she does to me. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. We're gonna take a break. We'll be right back. Okay.
Choose this. I am this. Mom, I didn't choose to be gay. Do you think I choose to be this different from everyone else? That I choose to make you and Dad this upset? And I choose to lose someone as beautiful and wonderful as Allison? And what about AIDS? I mean, suppose somebody wanted to be gay. Would they want to be gay now?
I don't know. And I don't want to know.
And you don't want to know me either.
I want you guys to meet David up here too. David, tell us about how you came out to your parents.
Well, it started, I was always told since I was a little kid that if you're ever gay, you're going to be disowned. That was the worst that could ever happen. Those people are sick. If you ever turn up, people get you help. You know, like, it was really laid out from a very young age.
Why do you think they said it so much? Do you think they suspected or
something? Yeah, I think they're very paranoid. I think that's why they ranked that high, because they had little inklings that this would possibly be true. And it was always put as the worst thing that could ever happen. So I always grew up trying to deny that I was, even though I knew I was. Then I got over that, and I thought, well, I can never tell them. I could just have to live a double life. And then after a couple years of that, I just couldn't stand it anymore. And I thought, this will be the only way that we can ever have a real relationship. I mean, his question was, why do you tell them? You always need, like, something from your parents. You're always looking for that, especially when you feel you're never going to get it. You still look with all hope that you are. So I decided, it was about a year ago, around this time, to go home. My parents live in Pittsburgh, and I had to tell her, and I didn't sleep the whole week. I couldn't eat. This was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. And
how did you actually say it?
To actually speak this, you know? So I went and I hung out for 2 days before I actually got the nerve to do it. And then I said, Mom, there's something I have to tell you. I think it's time we start being honest about some stuff, about my life. And she said, with who? Your life with who? I was like, not with anyone, just my life. Mm-hmm. And she was like, oh, I thought you were living with a girl or something. I mean, she was clinging to the denial that for that long.
Uh-huh.
And so I said, I thought, this is gonna make it even harder, but I have to tell her. So I just said, Mom, I'm gay. And she just kind of sat there like this, and she was breathing and everything. And I said, there's two things I want to tell you. First of all, nothing you did as a mother caused this to happen. It's not a failure. There's nothing wrong. You know, I'm totally happy. And second of all, I'm HIV negative, which means I'm not going to get AIDS. Mm-hmm. And she just said, well, it's just a matter of time before you do. Mm-hmm. And like, you know, here I was being as honest and open as I ever mm-hmm. have with her. I mean, I was really, really looking for something from her, and that's all she could say to me. Mm-hmm. And it crushed me.
Coming out, I know, was involved something really traumatic for you. And tell me what happened.
I came out to myself when I was 12 as bisexual, and I really started to accept it when I was 18, and I had an intimate love relationship with a friend of mine, a woman, in high school, and she actually lived with my mother and I for 2 weeks.
Okay.
And we slept in the same bed, and my mother, I don't
she
know what she thought.
Okay. And then what happened, though? I know you broke up with her, or she broke up with you.
We broke up in a way, and I've been suicidal for 13 years, and diagnosed as chemically manic depressive. And at that time, we were both depressed, and we were both talking about how wonderful it would be to die. And she had to leave to go someplace else to meet, I think it was her boyfriend, actually. And so I decided that, you know, without her, nobody understood me.
She was lovers with you, and she had a boyfriend?
And she had a boyfriend at the same time.
Okay.
And so I decided that it just wasn't worth it. There was nobody there for me. There was no hope for me, and there never would be anyone there. So I went and I bought sleeping pills at a local drugstore, and I took most of them in the mall bathroom that I was at. One dropped in the toilet, and I didn't take that one.
this is actually sadly common for gay and lesbian kids. I mean, it really
it's,
is.
It's very common.
I was suicidal for about 5 years.
You were also. Okay.
They say that 30% of all teenage suicides are committed over sexual identity crisis.
Okay. We're gonna take a break. We'll be right back. For tickets to Jane, write to Jane Tickets, 1481 Broadway, New York, New York, 10036, or call 212-730-8001 or 8011. Our ad on the show asking people who had come out to their parents, you know, if they were willing to come on with their parents and talk to us about it. We got a lot of really powerful calls, as you can imagine. But there's one that we got from a payphone, and I want to read you the transcript of what that call said. It said, "I've really wanted to come out to my parents for a while now, but I'm scared and I don't really know how to do it. So I wrote my parents a letter and I mailed it back to the house where we live. Yesterday, I saw the envelope still sitting on the table, and I was afraid my brothers would find it. They like to beat me up, and I was afraid they'd really hurt me if they read the letter. So I took the letter back, but my mom saw me do it and took it from me. She wanted to know why I would write a letter to them. What did I have to tell them in a letter? I told her I was writing to tell her that I'm gay. She started screaming and crying. She ran upstairs and started throwing my things out the window. Then she pushed me out the front door and locked it behind me. I started crying and I tried to talk to her through the door, but she wouldn't let me back in. Jane, I just want her to love me for who I am. I want her to know that. Mom, I just want you to love me." So at that point, William hung up the phone, and so we didn't ever have a phone number to get back to him. So William, if you're watching, we just want you to know that we're thinking about you and we support you. And Mom, if you're watching, we want you to really listen to what William said. Okay, I want you guys now to meet a mom, Leanne, who you have two gay sons.
Yes, I do.
Okay, you have Joel, who's up here with you, and you have another one too. And I heard that you found out that both of them were gay on the same day, basically. You found out from a counselor that your son Rick was gay, is that right?
No, actually,
I'm getting it wrong, okay.
I found out from Rick's boyfriend. I had called to talk to Rick, and his boyfriend talked to me on the phone. Rick wasn't home, and I asked if, I said, could I ask you a question, Dan? I go, is Rick gay? And Dan told me that I should probably be talking to my son about it. And I said, okay, let me ask you another question. I said, are you gay? And he said, yes, I am. And I said, well, then you've probably answered my first question. We had a lengthy conversation, and I went through a lot of emotions, a lot of different emotions, and then decided to talk to my son, myself, and...
Tell me, what are some of the emotions that you went through? And I want to get to your relationship with them now.
Well, the first emotion was, I had suspected this, but when it's right there and they're somebody, either someone or your son is telling you this, it's confirmed, and then you have to deal with it. And my main concern at that point was whether my son was happy with himself. I had all the concerns that any parent would have about AIDS and the hate crimes and who was going to hurt him. And those were my very main concerns. And I didn't want my son to have to be phony. That's the reason I chose to talk to him myself. And I told him I was disappointed that he hadn't talked to me about his lifestyle. And my concern was that he was happy with himself and that he could come home and bring his friends home and never have to be phony.
Okay. Joel, just real quick before we take a break, I want to hear from you about your mom. And has she ever seen you with a guy or anything? And what's that like?
I had a relationship for almost a year, and it was my senior year in high school. It was still kind of a touchy situation. My mom knew, my family knew, but yet they hadn't been around myself or my boyfriend, you know, ever really, you know, or interacted with us.
Because it sounds like your mom, and also I've heard your dad, are very, they're very cool.
I have the coolest parents in the world. Yeah.
I would love to have them all.
They all want you. You want to adopt some of these kids over here? Okay.
I just want to say something about all of my children. If there was anything I tried to teach my children, it was to be loving, compassionate, caring human beings. And whether I can take credit for that, I don't know, but that's what they are, and that's what I love about them. What they do in their bedroom is their own business.
Okay. So do you feel completely cool about bringing a guy home or whatever, or is that...
I'm sorry?
Would you feel completely cool about bringing a guy home? You're about to get to that.
I do feel completely cool about it, and I have.
Okay, mm-hmm. Great. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Is your boyfriend or girlfriend cheating on you? Tell us what they're up to, how you found out, and what you want to do next. Are you planning to stay with a cheater anyway? Fill us in, and you could be working it out on Jane. Call 212-730-8103.
Okay. Cleo, I just want to check back in with you, because it's been like a little over a half hour now since you got this news about your son. How are you doing?
Okay.
You feel okay about it? Yeah. Okay. I want to introduce you guys to Julie Spitzer here, who is, you're a psychotherapist, and you deal a lot with gay and lesbian patients, mm-hmm. and with their families, I guess. Yes. So, okay, she still has to learn, I think, as anyone would. It would take a while to learn, yes. to accept the whole thing fully and all of that. Do you have any advice for her and maybe for the other parents who aren't even up here? About how to accept this.
Yes, I think it's very important to stay in the here and now and to recognize that nothing can be done about what has happened and about the past, and that though the feelings are still there about what has happened in the past, that talking to each other about those feelings, about the past, it's too hard to be constructive, I think, when that happens, and that the more you stay in the moment with what you're feeling towards each other now and what's going on between you now, and keep an open mind and keep a sense of humor and hear each other out, things will go along fine. As I see they're going, there's a dialogue happening,
great.
There's a process happening.
I'm so
here
proud of
and it's
her.
Very exciting, and I'm
okay.
I'm happy for you.
So that's advice to parents in general who might be watching too. Okay, what do you want to say?
I disagree with all you gay people here. I think they're disgraces, and they know
they're
disgraces.
I think you're the one that needs that.
That's why you don't want to kill yourselves. And this guy should go marry a girl, and you should all go marry girls and stop giving this world AIDS.
The only reason I'm going to let you stay in the studio right now is because I think a lot of people unfortunately do feel this way, and it's important to bring it out.
These guys go with their girlfriends, and then I go with one of their girlfriends. I got to catch your disease.
Can I make a comment?
No way.
Wait a minute.
No,
it's not their disease.
Disease,
it's
okay?
Not their disease. Okay, go ahead. Respond to that.
I have a comment to make, and I think it was made by by Kevin's mom about it being a choice. And, I mean, you would have to be ignorant to think that if I had the choice to be straight or gay, that I wouldn't be straight because it would be so much easier. Because I don't have the choice. I am gay. I'm trying to make it work however I can. Mm-hmm. And it's people like you who set us back. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Who don't help.
Margaret, I think you've been really in denial. You've been contradicting yourself throughout the show, and I think that you should look at your son. He seems to be a really nice person, and I'm sure he accepts you for who you are, and you should accept him for who he is.
Are you going to take that? Are you going to take that advice? You're nodding. Kevin, you think she's going to take that advice?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I would really like my mom to be able to share part of my life and part of my relationship with Joel. We love each other very much, and he has AIDS, and chances are in 5 years from now, he'll be dead, and both my parents will have missed that whole part of my life and what it means to me.
Okay, Mom, do you want to try to get to know Joel a little bit better?
Yes, I do.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
To the mothers on the panel and any parents that are watching right now, instead of being ashamed and embarrassed of your child, you should really be happy and proud because they told you the hardest thing that anybody can ever tell anybody else, and they must have loved you and trusted you so much to tell you. So instead, you know, think
of
it
that way.
Be happy
that they opened up to you and that you have an open enough relationship. Okay, thanks. I really wanted to talk to you.
I would like to add to what she said as well as that. If you notice, a lot of them were suicidal and are suicidal. If you just accepted them for who they are, they wouldn't be that way. You prefer to have, if you love your children, you would prefer to have them here alive instead of dead.
Yeah, it's not just the parents' responsibility. Society in general needs to learn that kind of acceptance. Yeah.
To Leanne, I'd like to give you some credit because you, even though you may not agree with your son's lifestyle, you still had courage to come and help and be part of the show today, and a lot of the other parents didn't. So I wish you luck in the future, and I hope everything will be okay.
Thank you. I'd like to say,
go ahead.
On the God issue, the God that I choose to believe in, if you look around you, has created everybody differently. There's not even two people that have the same set of fingerprints. I know that because I work for the Department of Corrections in California. Every snowflake that falls out of the sky is different. And I think that simplistically, he spent a lot of time making every one of us different, and I think we need to love each other for our differences and not try to make everyone like we are.
This question's more or less directed at the man in the blue.
Hey, Dennis.
It's thing. I just don't I don't know how you could decide to do that, you know, to tell them. I mean, I understand that it's a part of your life and it's you, but if you knew that they're going to react so poorly and you do love them and want to talk to them, you know, I don't know if you'd survey your options as to
what am I supposed to do? Live a double lifestyle? Be straight on the weekends and be gay on Monday through Friday?
You could be a genius and not even know it. Find out what the heck intelligence is in the May issue of Sassy at your local newsstand.